I'm here today with Major Wendy Watts, who has a real interest in spiritual formation and spiritual disciplines. And this January, our theme has been New Year, New You. And this week, we're looking at new habits, in particular, those spiritual habits that we can develop that will help us to grow spiritually into the new that God is creating in us. So, Wendy, can you just help us to understand what is spiritual formation?
Yeah, spiritual formation, Robert Mulholland describes it as a process of becoming like Christ for the benefit of others.
So if we're talking about spiritual disciplines, what are they and how would you describe them?
Yeah, so spiritual disciplines also have other names like spiritual practices or holy habits. And all they are a way of opening ourselves up to God and to the Holy Spirit. So probably, if we've been on the spiritual journey for a little while, we've probably done a number of things. It might have been devotions or journaling, but it can be much greater than that. And so when you research spiritual disciplines, you can find a whole lot more.
And we actually have some on our website. We've been putting those up fairly regularly for people to look at and to use. So you sound like you know a lot more than I do about spiritual formation and spiritual disciplines, but how were you actually introduced to this concept of spiritual formation?
Yeah, I really like to be able to tell you a beautiful spiritual story of how that come about, but basically we're at the core offices at Carina, now Carindale Core, and the commissioner appointed us to the training college. Gavin was appointed as a training principal and I was appointed as a director of spiritual formation. I didn't know what that meant. Somebody laughed and said it had something to do with dance or something like that. I knew that wasn't me. So I had to go on a journey to find out what that was about. And part of that was just really bringing it in with what I already understood in terms of holiness, but I guess it was a more modern take maybe on our understanding of holiness and just growing in that way. So it's something that I had to teach and direct cadets in, and of course that impacted me as well.
Nice. So what particular spiritual disciplines have you found the most helpful in your spiritual journey?
Yeah, so there's lots and lots of them. There's probably about 50 of them that are available for us to try. For me, I found breath prayer really helpful. It's just something that once you develop and becomes part, you know, of your spiritual, I guess, a holy habit, that it can be really helpful at different times. You can just call upon and use that. Also, I really enjoy praying in colour as well, if I have time to sit down and draw and to meditate on a passage of scripture.
Yeah, and I think that we may have those two spiritual disciplines on our website, and if not, then we'll make sure that they're available. So what have you found the most difficult or challenging in your Christian walk?
Yeah, I would say consistency, being able to, you know, constantly press into God or to, you know, be engaged in those holy habits or spiritual disciplines consistently. But also, I guess the spiritual journey part is moving it from my head, understanding what God's trying to say to me, to my heart, really taking it in, but not just leaving it there, but living it out in my everyday life as well, so that it become more of my day-to-day living. Can't say I'm all over that, but it's just a challenge, and probably I don't think I'm alone in any of that.
No, that's true. So for people who are watching today, what encouragement would you have for them if they are wanting to work with the Holy Spirit in this transformation process? What encouragement would you give them?
Yeah, there's probably a lot I could say about that, but I guess just briefly, I grew up at a time in the church when, you know, I was taught to pray and to read my Bible, and you can become a little bit dry if that's all that you do. And so I'd encourage people to try different spiritual disciplines, maybe understand their own spiritual temperament to understand the best way that they can connect with God, and, you know, understand that for spiritual disciplines and holy habits, not it's not just a one size fits all. It's different things. So, you know, what works for one person may not work for the other. I know journaling was a great big thing, you know, the whole soap thing, and that's great if that works for you. But just because it doesn't work for you doesn't mean there's something wrong with you spiritually. It's probably means that you're a different season of life or have a different spiritual temperament. And so it's just experimenting with some of those disciplines to find out what the best way that God can speak to you.
Well, thank you for sharing with us today. That's been really helpful. It's our desire, and it's the desire of those who are watching today, that we will develop new habits because we want to work with the Holy Spirit as He transforms our life. And we most definitely want to become the new creations that God has planned for us. So we just thank you for your time and your words and your encouragement. And again, just to remind you that on our website, you will find some of these spiritual disciplines that Wendy has talked about, and praying that you'll find something that just helps you to continue to work with the Holy Spirit and to learn more about God and who God has created you to be.